Hello students, today we are going to start new chapter, chapter 10, measurement. First of all, we understand the meaning of measurement. Measurement is the action of measuring something, okay? Students, we need to measure a lot of things in our day-to-day life, okay? We measure time, weight, volume, temperature, length, speed, and etc. All the things that we measure are counted with the help of a unit, and that unit is the smallest quantity of something that we can measure. Okay? Students, some common measurements that we see around us, first, like a vegetable vendor weighing the vegetables, okay? A cloth merchant measures the length of a cloth, okay? And we, on regular basis, measure the time. And doctors measuring the temperature of a patient by a thermometer, okay? So, by this, students, we understand measurement is comparing an unknown quantity with the known quantity or a standard unit. Okay. Now, let's study about the things that can be measured. So, first of all is measurement of a length. Students, suppose you have to purchase a curtain for this window. So, how will you purchase the cloth of a curtain for this window, and how will you measure? So, first of all, you will measure the length of this window, and according that, you will purchase the curtain for this window. Okay? So, students, length tell us how long a thing is, okay? But earlier, people used their body parts to measure length, like hand span, cubit, and foot span. But these measuring length are not standard units. These are called non-standard units because measurement by using body parts are not accurate, okay? It's vary from one person to another person. For example, you can see if you measure the hand span of a child, 15-year-old, you can see the distance. But when I kept my, you can see the measurement will vary. Okay, so by this you can say, or we understand, that the measurement by using body parts are not accurate and it will vary from one person to another person. Okay, so students, nowadays, standard units are used to measure length. And what are that standard units? So, that standard units are meter, centimeter, millimeter, or kilometer. Students, basically, when we have to measure a length, we use meter. Okay. And we write meter as M. Okay. But when we have to measure the smaller length, okay, we measure it by centimeter or millimeter, and we write centimeter as cm and millimeter as mm. Okay, students, but when we have to measure larger lengths, we use it by kilometer, and we write kilometer as km. Okay, students, length is measured by using ruler, measuring tape, or meter rod. Okay. Now, next is precautions should be taken while using the ruler. Okay. So, students, you can see here I have taken a ruler of 30 centimeter. Okay. And here a line is drawn. So, how will we measure the length of this line? So, first of all, we will start from here, okay, and keep this line to this point at initial point, first point, okay, and see up to where this line point, last line is pointed, okay. So, you can see it has pointed, now you can see from here to here, it is 10 centimeter. So the length of this line is 10 centimeter. Okay. So by this we have to measure the length of any thing. Okay. Hope you understand these things. Now you have to write terms you need to know in your G-Science copy, and here also some units are given, like 10 millimeter equals to 1 centimeter, that you have to know. So this and this also you have to write in your copy and learn it also. Okay, thank you.